Memory is a tricky thing. Why do we remember some things, but not others? For example, some of you watching this are going to do a great job remembering how many kittens have been hidden throughout this video, and others just won't have any clue. But why is that? Our brains have a variety of ways in which we remember and learn things. We also have a number of ways that we forget things. In fact, in most cases, when you forget something, it's not that you're bad at remembering, rather, it's just that your brain is reorganizing so it can focus on other more important memories. Leading neuroscientists theorize that your brain actually stores everything that has ever happened to you in your head somewhere. It just only forms the neural pathways to remember things that it deems important. Theories like this could explain how some people who suffer traumatic brain injuries can wake up speaking entirely new languages or reciting lines to movies and books word for word. Memories, or rather the neural pathways that your brain forms to recall them, get stronger each time you remember that thing. Actively recalling certain memories over and over again can strengthen those pathways and increase your chances of remembering a thing. But if our brains remember everything that ever happens to us and memories are just the strongest neural pathways, what's the best way to learn and form new memories when we want to? Several studies show that quizzes and practicing remembering something is far better than just brute force trying to memorize something through repetition. That's because these procedures actually let your brain form those neural pathways rather than just thinking about forming those neural pathways for a given memory. One study separated students into different groups. One group just studied words and their translations, another was constantly quizzed on the translations, another was quizzed until they got the translations right 3 times, and the final fourth group was the same as the third, but researchers gave them more time in between quizzes. Researchers found that after a week, the groups that were quizzed got 80% of the words right, while the other non-quiz groups got only 25% or below right. This means that the best way to remember things is by practicing those memories, like through flashcards, sample tests, and quizzes. The way we remember things is ultimately by strengthening the neural pathways in our brain. Every time we build those pathways, we make it easier and faster for our brain to travel down them in the future. Another common way that people memorize things is through something called a memory palace. This technique places the things you need to remember in a place, generally a place you know well, like your house. Then you add in weird associations to specific objects back to what you're memorizing. For example, maybe you'll envision a turkey wearing a hat on the sofa. This might be used to help you remember that you need to go buy formal attire for the upcoming Thanksgiving dinner where you'll be eating turkey. It may sound crazy, but this method works. It's basically hijacking the existing neural pathways for that familiar place and throws fresh things in, making them easier to remember. But enough about how to remember things, let's talk about how memories are encoded into your brain. Generally, memories, or experiences, come in as sensory inputs from your various senses. These get put into the brain generally through your hippocampus along with the frontal cortex. These two parts of the brain are believed to be responsible for analyzing events and making decisions on whether they need to be remembered. This process takes short-term memories and encodes them as long-term ones. At the core of memories, they're simply electrical and chemical signals all linked together. When brain cells fire in different patterns, a certain memory can be recalled, sort of like typing in your PIN code to access your bank account. New research is also suggesting that brain wiring isn't some permanent function, rather it constantly changes, getting re-optimized and reworked to keep up with the present. That means that sometimes you forget things you've known for a while simply because your brain needed to reorganize. But back to the focus of this video. How many kittens did you spot? Post the number in the comments. I'll pin the first comment that gets it right. So that's how we remember things.